Assalamu alaikum. Hi everybody. How are you? I hope you are doing well. Okay. Today we are going to see an interesting lesson. Already we have started this lesson. Before starting the lesson, I want to ask you some questions. Did you see my video regularly? I hope you are all watching my videos. But some students only asking doubts, very few students only. So you are welcome. Okay, you can ask any questions to me if you have any doubt. Okay, so today we are going, in this video lesson we are going to see chapter 3, whitewashing the fence. Very interesting story. It's a foreign story, understand? So it's written by American author and Umari Samuel Langone Clemens. Its pen name is Mark Twain. Okay, so two important major works by him is The Adventures of Tom Sawyer and The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. So this lesson was extract from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. Understand? So it is a story about a boy who is very, very wit. Okay, it is a story about a boy who is very, very wit, a very knowledgeable boy. Understand? And then very intelligent. And he was very, very studious. He was studious to do what his aunt wanted him to do. Okay, so he was very studious, means dull. Okay, he was boring in doing the same work. So who is giving the work? His aunt is giving the work. Understand? So his aunt is giving this type of work. So he was doing that work very, very tediously. Okay, very dull. He felt dull. Understand? So in the first paragraph, what we have seen. So it's a Saturday morning. It's a Saturday morning. It's a fresh and bright nature. Okay, they are describing about the village. And then what else? So everyone was had a music in their hat. Heart. Heart means what? It's everyone was enjoying the nature. All are happy. Understand? And then in that locust tree, the flowers are blooming. The flowers are blooming. Fragrance around the village. A sweet smell is coming. Understand? So they are describing about the village. So in that village only, the small boy, who is the character? Small boy, Tom. Okay, he was walking. And last class I told you, no, I taught you. What is that? He had a bucket of whitewash. So he had a bucket, and in that he was started to whitewash the fence. Fence means what? Wall. Okay, understand? So and then what happened? Doing the work continuously, he felt very, very melancholy. Last class I wrote you, what do you mean by melancholy? Melancholy means sadness. He felt very sad doing the same work. Okay, and then what happened? So he was looking the fence. Oh, this is 30 yards of broad fence, 9 feet high. How can I whitewash this? So he was very, very bored. And then what happened? His heart was burdened. He was small boy, no? So he was very, very sad. And then what happened? So he again doing is dipping his brush in that that whitewash, and then he started whitewashing that. And then he was after some time he sat down on a tree box. Okay, in a discouraged way. Understand? He was sad. You can see this picture. So the boy was sitting under a tree box. Understand? So what happened? That time only Jim came there. Okay, Jim is a very, very sporty boy. So he was singing a song and he was entering in that area. And then what happened? Yeah, Jim's duty is to bring water from the town pump. Okay, was Jim's duty bringing water from the town pump. And then this work was disliked by Tom. Okay, Jim liked this, okay, bringing water from the water pump, okay, town pump. But Tom doesn't like this work, okay. But somehow now he was interested to do that. Who? Tom. Why? Because in that town pump, there are number of friends is there. There are number of friends is there. So they have described as white mulatto, black boys and girls were always there, waiting their turn, resting, trading, playthings, quarreling and fighting. So in that town pump, there are so many friends are there. So Tom thought, so better we can go to that place and we can enjoy with the friends. He thought like that. Instead of painting this wood fence, I can go to that a town pump, okay, because I can meet so many friends there. And then he remembered that although the pump was only 150 hours, Jim never got back with a bucket of water under an hour, and even then somebody generally had to go after him. So Jim was very particular about that work. He never gave this work to anybody. So now what happened? So Tom is going to converse with Jim. Is going to talk with Jim because he was boring in whitewashing the fence. He want to play a trick. Okay. So what Tom was speaking to Jim, we are going to see. Tom said, "Say Jim, I will fetch the water if you will whitewash them." So Tom was asking to Jim, "I will bring the water. Okay. Can you whitewash for some time?" So he is asking. Tom was asking to Jim. Understand? So it's a beautiful story. They are small children. They are asking for something. Okay. They are conversing and telling about their what are the things they are doing. They are exchanging. Okay. And then what happened? Tom is asking to Jim. "Say Jim, I will fetch the water, you will whitewash some." "So I will bring the water, can you whitewash for some time?" he is asking. Jim shook his head and said, one thing I want to say you, very very important. Here, the spelling is different, okay. For example, I'll tell you. Here they given git, and then what the spelling? Di this. What is this? Can you read this? This is not English word, but how they are pronouncing the same they have written. Okay, some of the paragraph the author has written like that. Okay, novel is like they can write each and every description. Okay, oh ye, that fell in my leg, I have pain, like that. They will each, everything they will describe. Okay, so in the same way, git, this is mean get this. Okay, you cannot read this. So it's a way of pronunciation, the same pronunciation they given that spelling. Okay, so Tom is asking, "I will bring the water, can you do the whitewashing work?" he is asking. And then Jim is shook his head, "No," he is telling and giving the reason. "Can't Mass Town, only missus, she told me I go to and get this water and not stop fooling around with anybody. She say she speak Mass Town to ask me to whitewash, and so she told me go long and tend to my own business. She would tend to do whitewashing." So Jim was telling, "No, I cannot do this work because Ole is a one character, woman character. Okay, so Mrs. Ole told me you should not give your work to anybody. Okay, Tom will do his work and you have to do your work. Okay, you should not exchange your work. Understand? So she already told to Jim. So he is telling, so I cannot do your work. You have to do your work and I have to do my work. So Mrs. Hole, if she see me like that, she will scold me. Okay. So the reason was given by Jim. Okay, understand? And then now the reply comes from Tom. Oh, never you mind what she said, Jim. Okay, now we said Tom is telling. Oh, never mind that. Okay, never mind that. What she said. Don't bother about that. What she said. That's the way she always talk. So, Tom is explaining. She always talk like that only. You don't want to bother about that. Give me the bucket. Please give me the bucket. I will go and bring the water. Who told Tom? Okay, it's a conversation between Tom and Jim. I won't be gone only a minute. She won't ever know. So Tom is telling, I will go quickly and bring the water. She never know that. Okay. Oh, I doesn't mask Tom. Only Mrs. She would take and head off often me. Deed she would. So, no, I cannot do that. I cannot do your work because if she is become very angry, I cannot escape from her. Jim told to Tom. She never does that. She talks awful, but talk don't hurt. Anyways, it don't if she don't cry. Jim, I will give you a marble. I will give you a white alley. So, what Tom was telling to Jim is, she talks very angrily, but she won't do it in action. Okay, she will talk very angrily, but he won't show in action. And then, at last, Tom was telling, I will give you a marble. I will give you a white alley. White alley means a fine white marble used by boys for shooting in the ring. Understand? So everything in your text they have given. So white alley is a white marble. The small boys is used to play the marble. You know, it's a round shape like that. Okay? It's a, the boys will use this marble as a playthings. Understand? So now, Tom is in a tricky way, he is to attract Jim and he is telling, don't worry about Mrs. Hole, I will give you a marble. Okay, I will give you a marble and I will give you a white alley. So, white alley is it's a type of marble and the boys will use to play with that. Jim behind to waver. So, Tom was attracting Jim. Okay, so Tom was attracting Jim and telling, I'll give you this marble. He is telling like that. So, now Jim was waver, thinking. Okay, what can I do? White alley, Jim, it's a bullita. So, bullita means shooting a marble. It's a type of plaything. Okay, white alley, Jim, and it's a bullita. So, it's a very playful thing. My dad's a mighty marble, I tell you. But Mars Tom, it's very powerful. Afraid only misses. So, Jim is telling, your marble is very, very mighty. It's very, very big. He's telling. And besides, you will, if you will, I will show you my soto. So, it's a conversation between that two boys. What is it? Jim and Tom. Suddenly, he's telling, I will show my toe. You can see that. Little things they are. What is that? They are conversing. Jim was only human. This attraction was too much for him. He put down his pail and took the white alley and bent over the toe with absorbing interest while the bandage was being unbound. So, what was Jim's work? You want to go to the town pump and you have he has to bring the water. But now Tom was attracting Jim and showing the marble. And then what happened? And now Jim was seeing the marble, taking the in hand and seeing the marble. In another moment, he was flying down the street with his pail and a tingling rear. Tom was whitewashing with vigor. So what happened? He's seeing the marble and he was going back, returning to his work. Understand? So now, again Tom was continuing his work. Vigor. What do you mean by vigor? Active strength and force. Okay? He was in a force way, he was painting the fence. Understand? And then Aunt Polly was retiring from the field with a slipper in her hand and triumph in her eye. So this is the third character. What is this? Aunt Polly. Aunt Polly, she is the woman is giving works for these children. Understand? So we have completed 4 pages. So we 2 more pages is there to complete the lesson. So it's a very long lesson. So all should read the text at home. Those who don't have the text, watch the video 2 or 3 times. Okay. And then you can ask me if you have any queries. Okay. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you.